Hi, welcome to BTBS. Today we will do OCP4 installation by UPI on KVM. For that, we need to download my repository. Here is J-House OpenShift. So copy, clone download, and then go back to terminal. Here is a Fedora 28, and I'm in the temp directory. I will clone the repository. Before you start to demonstrate it, you need to make sure if KVM is running well and DNS masquerade in Network Manager is set properly. In my environment, KVM is running well and Network Manager set DNS to DNS masquerade. Now we need to update config file for demonstration. There is config.example file, so you can copy it to yours and update it. In my case, I already updated the config file in main folder. Let's see the detailed information briefly. The first part is mandatory, so you have to update those parameters. The second part is optional, so you can use default one or you can update it. Here, cluster name, UPI, OCP version 4.1, worker node is 1, master node is 1, and pool secret pass is from try.openshift.com, SSH public key is from your laptop, and RedHawk OS kernel, RedHawk OS init RAM file system, RedHawk OS image, that is BIOS image. And 192.168.222.1 is for web server. For demo, I will update these storage parameters just for demo. And also, I will update it some of parameter here. Bootstrap master, worker, VM, disk size, memory, and vCPU. So now, you are ready to use my script. Okay, now I will initialize the project. If you are not familiar with the steps, please watch OpenShift 4 installation by UPI on KVM overview video first. Okay, it created inventory file and terraform tfvar file and also bootpxl file. And now we will deploy LB and set up network, all stuff in prep step. Now it's done. Now you got this environment. You have HTTPD and Network Manager DNS and Docker Matchbox server and KVM LB. And also LB has HA proxy. So you are ready to deploy OpenShift version 4. Let's do it. To deploy OpenShift VM and install OpenShift version 4, we will use OCP step. It's done, which means KVM VMs for OpenShift version 4 are running now. First, let's show you there is worker 0 and master 0, bootstrap and LB. Then we will execute this command line to wait bootstrap complete. And I will update this installation dir to UPI. It will wait until bootstrap is completed. It will take more than 20 minutes. So I will show you some more stuff. First, I want to check Bootstrap journal log. For that, I need to go inside the Bootstrap, go as at bootstrap.upiexample.com. Yes. All right. Now you can copy this command line and paste it. So it is waiting for etcd cluster. That is good. And it will start up soon. And we can go out here. And also we can go to lb ssh CentOS, because we are using CentOS for lb. lbupiexample.com. Okay, we are in. And I want to show you HA proxy config file. So there is ingress HTTP, ingress HTTPS for worknode, and API and machine config server is for Bootstrap master. That's good. And next, we will go to master server, SSH core master 0.upi. example.com. Yes. Okay, we are here and we can take a look at it, the journal log, but there is nothing actually now because there is trying to get information from Bootstrap, but it is not starting up properly. So there are a lot of errors, but it doesn't matter. It will be okay. All right, we take a look at LB Bootstrap master. I will execute OpenShift command line to wait Bootstrap is completed. Okay. This is Bootstrap VM. I will show you what's going on Bootstrap. Okay, it's done. Bootstrap is completed. Now we need to do pause step. Pause step contain update registry storage to empty dir and execute waiting for OpenShift install completed. Jacket post. As you see, there is no registry yet, so we need to wait a little bit more. We will execute this command line like 5 minutes later. During the time, I will show you master log. In here, I want to show you how many containers are running periodically. Now we can execute the command line again. Okay, it is patched. And it tried to remove the Bootstrap from LB. Then we are waiting for OCP4 install completed. Okay, it's done. So OpenShift version 4 is installed. Today, we install OpenShift version 4 using UPI on KVM. It is the exactly same as bare metal. Thank you.